Parents of Reddit, what's something your kid or kids have admitted to you that you wish they never would have told you? Similar to canoodlers, I told my blind son when he lost his first tooth at age 6 that he looks like a jack-o'-lantern. He immediately ran over to the full-length mirror and twisted his head every way he could to try to see his mouth. He has a little peripheral vision. When he couldn't see himself, he climbed back in bed with me and said, "Daddy, I wish I could see my smile." Broke my heart. My son told me he was tired of living in his body. He is 14 years old and has spastic cerebral palsy. Even though he always has a smile on his face, I always questioned in my mind whether or not he was in pain. He is developmentally and mentally age appropriate, speech is normal, and his disability is mainly physical. He walks with a walker, wears leg braces, and is constantly fighting his muscle tone. The sentence that he spoke killed me. I wasn't ready. We cried together, and because he's a friggin' awesome kid, he ended up wiping my tears and telling me it was okay. Most days are great, but the ones that aren't are really sad. I love him, and I wish I could take away his pain. My son admitted to me that he had sex with 2 girls while I was in the kitchen baking him a cake for his 16th birthday. One was keeping watch at the door while the other had sex with him, then they switched. I remember them shyly leaving the house after I yelled down the hall to tell him his cake was finished. We have always had open dialogue about everything, but this was one piece I could have gone without knowing. I hate my new gold-digging stepmother and her 2 bitchy rat-faced daughters. My son then proceeded to detail words and actions of the 3 of the above. He was already in therapy, so I mentioned it to the therapist, who wasted no time bringing them all in for a family therapy session. My son repeated what he told me. His dad offended his new wife. She abruptly left the room after she told my son to fuck off. He was 12, and my ex ran after her. My son refused to ever live with /see/share any part of his life with his dad again. I don't so much wish he never told me. I wish it never happened how it all went down. I have been very open with my daughter, 18F, about relationships, sex, etc. I can't say I really wanted to hear today that she is having 6, but on the other hand, I'm glad she told me so I can get her some birth control. It's just really uncomfortable when your child, who is now an adult, tells you she's having sex. But I didn't express that, of course, and talked to her again about birth control, condoms, emotional stuff with relationships, etc. My elder son was, at the time, 2. He walks up to me with this disgusted look on his face, grabs my hand, pulls it towards his mouth and spits out a chewed up turd. He then says, "Daddy, I bite poo." I wish to God I hadn't seen, known of, or been nearby for that. My dad doesn't use Reddit, but I know for a fact what he'd comment. His dad was an alcoholic. He said he'd beat the shit out of us if we ever joked of it or became one. At 18 I became one, went from hating the stuff to having a dependency and far too much of it. He thankfully didn't beat the shit out of me, but he sure treats me different and with some distaste. My daughter went into a serious downward spiral around age 15. She was suicidal and eventually ended up being institutionalized. I was visiting her and she told me one part of her story, which was she was raped in her school bathroom. That hurt like hell to hear. The doctors were also helping her deal with something else, hearing voices. When I was sitting at the same visit, I asked her, "So, do you hear voices right now?" She said yes. I paused and then asked her, "So what are they saying?" And she said, "Kill yourself. Kill yourself now. Kill yourself. Kill yourself now." After a rough day of me being cranky because his behavior was driving me nuts, I went into my 7-year-old's room while he was in the shower and found a picture he had drawn of a stick figure in the middle of 2 rows of stick man heads. The speech bubble for the head said "ha ha 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 ha," and there was an arrow pointing to the middle stickman with a comment that read, "His name, the worst boy in the whole world." This broke my heart. I ended up crossing out the ha-ha-ha bits and replacing them with "we love you and you're the best," and crossed out "worst boy" and replaced it with "most wonderful boy," and left it on his desk for him to find. When he found it and came in to see me, the happy smile on his face made it all better again. Dialogue between me and my mom. I've been going through sporadic episodes of psychosis for as long as I can remember, but it was always dismissed as typical asshole child syndrome. When I was involuntarily admitted to inpatient from my university, my mom finally took me seriously. Mom, do I scare you? Yes. I got slapped with some perspective that day. Not a parent, but an aunt. My niece was abused by her uncle by marriage, no relation to me, for over a year. She's only 8 now and this happened from around 5 to 6 years old. After we talked about it among the adults, we agreed not to bring it up, unless she started the conversation. She has taken it all to heart, and internalized a lot of negative feelings about herself, because of what she suffered. One day, we were playing a board game, and she just says, out of nowhere, "I wish I would die." We talked about it, and I did my best to comfort her, but nothing has ever broken my heart like hearing those words come out of her mouth. She's my favorite person in the world, and she's going through hell right now. Sometimes, the world is really unfair. This is coming from me, 17 meters. About a year ago I admitted to my parents that I was depressed, and had been to the point of almost pulling the trigger. After I told them, my mom insisted on me talking to her every day for at least an hour about emotional stuff. I'm glad I told them, but when my mom does that kind of crap it makes me feel awkward, and wish I had never told her. I'm 15, but my parents haven't talked to me the same since I told them I've been pretty depressed. The initial look on their faces is crystal clear on my mind. My mom looked contorted and fearful, with my dad's stern look staring at me, a soft look I've never really seen before then. It broke my heart to see them like that, and I hate that I even told them that. Not my child, but at 19 I told my mother I was addicted to coke. She took it better than I thought. She's a pretty great woman, but she later told my dad, and he didn't talk to me for a while. I was hoping he'd be angry and lecture me on how much of a dumbass I was, but instead I got the "I'm disappointed in you" treatment, / I had to quit, after telling her to, and withdrawals were awful for little 19-year-old me. Growing up my mom was a real hard ass, sort of like an Asian tiger mom. She didn't want me doing anything that didn't help my grades in school, so I couldn't hang out at friends' houses, watch TV, play video games, etc. She was / is also slightly neurotic, and whenever anything goes slightly out of line she either flies into a fit of rage or breaks down sobbing really hard. All that meant a lot of stress on kid me, and I worked my ass off to always be on top of the class in grade school. I was also constantly afraid of making her angry, so I never spoke up to her, or really, never spoke to her at all, about anything. I moved to a bigger city right before middle school, and the kids there were much more competitive, so I ended my first year there about 2 or 3 spots from the top. My mom lost it, and started saying stuff, like she wished she never had me, how I didn't love her enough to put effort in school, making me hate myself for being such an ungrateful kid. I suppose my mom thought this would make me a little more motivated, but it had the complete opposite effect, and made me hate going to school every day. By the time I was 16 I was a depressed wreck, skipping classes, walking around aimlessly, wherever my feet would take me. My mom sees my report card and she goes apeshit. Just, absolutely crazy. Said things I don't even want to remember. I hated myself more than anything else that night. Long story short, I tried to kill myself, slipped a note under her bedroom door telling her how I was sorry for being such a disappointment, and how I didn't want to be a burden to her anymore. Fortunately I didn't die, but since then things have only gotten worse. She basically acts like I don't exist. Some days I would catch her looking at me, and I see a fear in her eyes, like I'm some kind of monster. I went back to school, worked to support myself during college, and I'm now a pretty well-adjusted person in my early 30s with a promising career. I've never heard from my mom since I moved away, and now we've pretty much lost contact. Sometimes I think of trying to find her, but then again I don't think she'd want me to. I don't know how my mom feels about all this, but mom, I wish I never told you how much I hated my life. My sister, 19 years old, told my dad that, as soon as she had the money she was getting the fuck out of here, that she never gets treated well, and that she wishes she still lived with our biological parents, who are drug addicts in NJ, USA. We are both adopted. My dad wakes up at 3 a.m. every day, works from 5 a.m. to 6 p.m. anywhere from 5 to 7 days a week, pays for her schooling 100%, puts his job on hold for her, goes out of his way to do little things to cheer her up unprovoked, and continues to do so despite her bullshit and verbal abuse. He snapped when she said it, and told her that if she has any more outbursts he was going to pack her shit up and change the locks. But I know he won't. Instead, he'll just wonder if he's a shitty dad, if his adopted kids, sister and I, wish our parents never adopted us, and suppress all of those sad feelings until everything is swept under the rug again, and she sweet talks him, because she wants something. Every time she does this shit, I can totally see the invisible weight piling up on him, and he gets really quiet and withdrawn. Poor papa. My mom told me that it was when I said I didn't the world was a good place. This was after her getting a terminal liver failure diagnosis and my father going through an awful time trying to quit drinking. I thought life was painful and didn't really believe it was going to get better. She just looked disappointed and said, "I always thought you were different." She just kind of walked away and died a month and a half later after pretty much going crazy due to the liver failure. I'm a college freshman and I know exactly what my mother would say. I received a full scholarship to go to an elite, top 30 ranked college that is about an hour away from home. I moved into the dorms there and everything went downhill from there. I had no friends and my floor mates ostracized me, and I sunk from someone with depressive tendencies to thinking about and planning my suicide all day. About a month ago I moved back home, and my parents couldn't understand what the problem was. My mom was folding laundry the first night I was back home, and asked me could it have really been that bad. And I told her that if I kept living at school, that I wouldn't have lived to see Christmas. Just from the look on her face I know she wished I never told her that. My nephew is in the first grade this year. He is having difficulties with the material this year, and is awaiting testing for learning disabilities. The other day my sister was a little stressed out, and he said, "It's okay mommy, your brain is like mine. When you try to think your brain just goes all crazy." It's really heartbreaking to hear that coming from him. He's an amazing kid who can rattle off facts about the things he's interested in, like Egypt, tornadoes, volcanoes, trains, and so many more subjects. He's so smart and funny, he just has trouble learning the way his school is teaching. Not a parent, but once when I was 14 I had just gotten a glimpse of who my mom was at my age, and for some reason I told her I probably wouldn't be friends with her if we had gone to the same school. I was thinking personality wise, she was a basketball player with tons of friends. I was more of the loner slash average kid who played around with weed. She played it off, but I could tell she was a bit hurt, and I wish I could take it back. Wow, super relevant thread. Tonight over dinner, my 17-year-old sister casually brought up the topic of bleached assholes. My parents are pretty chill, and we all laughed about it. But then my sister proceeded to ask if I had bleached my asshole before Dustin, my ex, licked my butthole in front of my mother and father. It was a long, awkward meal. I'm the kid in this scenario, but definitely my issues with depression. They are supportive and helpful, but it is harder to tell them now when I'm struggling with any emotional problem. They are terrified of what I might do if I'm really upset, so I can't be sad in front of them for more than 5 minutes before they insist I should just be over it already. I love them with all my heart, but whenever I'm in a horribly sad mood I know that I should reach out to friends for help first.